good morning.
Good morning. Please mention your name. You know, someone is read me. Please mention your name so that you know it will be helped for attendance and all.
Yes, sir. Mahadevi Biradar.
Yeah. Your name is correct, ma'am. But another name is there. That is the read me. I don't know who is he. So just change your name. Rename option is there. You can rename. So put your correct name. Actually, yesterday's session is over. Now there will be sessions in today also. So I'm yesterday whatever we have discussed, I just repeat once again.
So where should I put the name, sir?
Your name is correct, ma'am. No issue.
Okay,
some persons maybe I don't know who is he. Redmi is there. He can change his name.
Thank you.
You will be got the yesterday sessions, you know, video lectures. So you will be go through it, no issue. Whatever the in the first session, the what are the introductions and all. So I just eliminating those things. So you know the time will be reduced, and I will be come on the topic. And rest of things, whatever the introductions and all, whatever the discuss yesterday, you can see from you know from the YouTube video, whatever already given to all of you. So you can see. So just I coming on the topic, whatever the topics we have, I'm just coming. And myself, Dr. Sudipta Chakraborty, I am the actually taking the total, you know, this FDP. And after that, we'll be plan another FDP for the, you know, different of microcontroller like Peak, like others microcontroller. So now we are just talking about the 8051 microcontroller, and some persons may be using the electrical engineering ID. Who is he? Okay, let's start. Whatever I am discussed yesterday, I'm just recapping, and you know, I'm given another times it will be, so it will be help for you. And whatever the last day I am discussed, everyone is audible to me.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
You can see in my name there are two things is that another is you know one copy is there it is nothing but a you know my whatever I write you can see whatever I write you can see na the this page one copy is there the name is electrical engineering department Dumka engineering college can you see
yes sir
very good thank you so you just look at that particular you know basically whatever I discussed yesterday first I discussed that what about the 8085 and what about the 8051 means where it is required you know 8085 whatever we have in our laboratories I mean your laboratory whenever you teach the students you just see that you know the big kit and it's big kit there are several ICs is there like 8255 like DMA controller all the peripherals ICs are connected and it's a big you know it's a big big one and if I'm talking about the you know first of all I just don't mind I'll just mute everyone if you require you can unmute and you talk okay so basically 8085 is nothing but a working in a kit not in a individual so it is in 8085 there is a no memory no IO port all are connected externally memory IO port all are connected externally and you know it is a big kit and after that this kit will be working before that is not possible at all so that is the main part of the 8085 so 8085 cannot work alone it will be work like in kit so in 8051 if total kit whatever you have and what are the cost of 8085 kit not less than from the 6k and it will be 10k 12k something like that so in an average we are assuming that this is a 6k to 10k the cost and you know total kit if you are assuming in a single IC so that will be in 8051 that will be in 8051 8051 is nothing but a so if 8085 you know bigger in size and 8051 in small in size so bigger in size and small in size so if I'm compare with a cost you know one is same configuration one is a laptop one is a desktop so laptop will be the most costly but remember one thing is that if I'm talking about the 8051 so total kit in a single IC so cost should be more than that but you know it will be available from 70 rupees and onward means you are given a 100 rupees so you will be get a good microcontroller so you know cost effective is too less so that's why in the market and in your project and our project our student project everywhere we are using the 8051 first of all why student will be learn and why the faculty is required for microcontroller that is a very important questions you know and today's aspect if it is not required so why we learn it is a very important thing so first of all in our you know our college whatever we are you know teach that is the two types of company we are coming one is a software company and another is a core company one is a software company and another is a core company and you know for software company you required three different subject to get the job because everyone maximum 80 to 90% student you know doing their engineering to get the job in you know very easy way or very faster way so maybe 10% student is there those students are doing their mtech or you know go to the higher studies and all but 90% students to come in the btech because of due to the job so you know for the software company you required like C data structure numerical java oracle python etc and for core company there are three subject is required three subject you know just like your core paper for say EC I can say like DSP like microwave like antenna add so on and so forth so three subject from the core company and three subject from the software company together you know six subject he should be learned without six subject he cannot get it So three subject from the core company and three subject for the software company. These six subject should be required. And you know, these six subject, your student will be learned as they are the master of that particular subject, because interview is not a game like 50 over match. It is just like a game of T20 match. So they may be asked 1 and 2 questions. If you are give the answer, so they will be get the job, otherwise not. So basically you need 3 subjects over here and 3 subjects over here, so you need 6 subjects. So one subject which is a common for your syllabus, that is MUP and MUC, you can given in a both. So this subject will be reduced to 5, not 6, it will be 5. So six subject will be reduced to 5. That's the main important of this subject, microprocessor and microcontroller, which is be given to the software company as well as the core company. And you know, whenever the students is going for the interview, maybe the interviewers from the different branch. Maybe one is coming from the mechanical, another one is coming from the electrical, another one coming from the EC, something like that. So one subject is common for every branch, that is the MUP and MUC. Each subject is available to every students. Say if I am talking about the mechanical, then mechatronics, there is a subject. In that particular subject, this subject is there. So whenever the interviewers is coming, they can ask the questions, without any questions, how they will be select the people and all. So that's the reason this subject is very, very much important for the students. And why its subject is important for the faculty and us? That we are doing some research work. So research work means some project. We require microcontroller very, very, very much because it is a cost effective. And we are given the project like mini project, like micro project, like major project. In three different projects, we can use the microcontroller as well. So microcontroller project, very easy to implement, you very cheapest. Students can maybe given 200 or 300 rupees, so they will be get a good circuit. Means maybe for the temperature measurement, maybe for the level measurement, for the maybe electrical, you can create as an energy meter for using a microcontroller, something like that. So many kind of innovative idea, if you can think about, so it can be done using 8051 microcontroller or any other microcontroller. So that's why this subject is very much important for us also. So that's why I'm just given brief description about those. So what about, I am talking already, this is the how to, what are the importance and all. So 8085 and 8051, basically if I am compared, the cost is effective in 8051. So if I am talking about the 8085, what are the clock frequency? Clock frequency means operating frequency. Operating frequency is nothing but a 3 to 5 megahertz. If I am talking about 3 to 5 megahertz, means it will be working in a 3 to 5 megahertz. And 8051 is nothing but a 12 megahertz. If I am compare with that 8085 with 8051, if I am assuming this is 8085 in 5 megahertz, so it will be near about 2.5 times. It will be near about 2.5 times. So 2.5 times. So that's the important, 8085 and 8051. As the frequency is higher, so it will be the faster. As T is nothing but a inversely proportional with frequency, T is equal to 1 by F. So as frequency is nothing but a 12 megahertz, and over here 5 megahertz, so time is required is less over here. So it will be faster with respect to 8085, and cost also is reduced. And another very important thing is that in 8085, its HAP address bus is 16 bit. Address bus is 16 bit, and data bus also 8 bit. Over here also the same. Address bus in 8051 is 16 bit, and data bus also 8 bit. So what are the basic, bus? What are the requirement of bus? Bus is nothing but every day we are going through bus. So bus is nothing but a communication medium, nothing else. So with the help of bus, we can generate the address. How the address is generated, I am just talking about what is the how the address is generated. But remember, the same address bus, same address, but what are the memory capacity? So if I'm talking about the 8085 memory capacity, then you can see the address is nothing but a 16-bit. Bit is stand for binary number. So as a binary number, you know, so you will be get 16 binary number. 16 binary number. And all are should be one. So it will be stand from 00000H to FFFFH. So how many locations are there from 00000 to FFFF? One number have a two state, 0 and 1, that's why 2. Sir, how many numbers was there? 16, that's why 2 to the power 16. Sir, what are the memory capacity of there? Means memory capacity, how much memory can store in a particular memory locations? That is 8-bit. So every memory location can store 8-bit. So it will be into 8-bit. So 2 to the power 16 into 8-bit is nothing but a, how much? So 2 to the power 16 means 2 to the power 6 into 2 to the power 10. And bit is stand for byte. So 64, 2 to the power 10 is nothing but a K, kilobyte. 64 kilobyte is a memory capacity of 8085. Similarly, you know, in 8051, 64 kilobyte memory capacity for program memory. Program memory 64 kilobyte and data memory 64 kilobyte. So together 128 kilobyte. Whereas, you know, for 8085 and 8051, same address, address lines, 16 address lines. But if I'm talking about the, you know, the memory capacity, so memory capacity is twice. Twice means 128 kilobyte. So that is nothing but a, you know, memory capacity of for program memory is 64 kilobyte, data memory is 64 kilobyte, together is 128 kilobyte. So that's the basic difference in, you know, 8085 and 8051. 8051, if I'm talking about, so twice memory capacity with respect to 8085, whereas address bus basically same. There is a no change of address bus. Address bus basically same. How it is possible? It is possible using the architecture, you know, in 8085, basically creating using von Neumann architecture. And you know, 8051 is basically created the Harvard architecture. In von Neumann architecture, program memory and data memory in the same, but there is a no distinguish between program memory and data memory. But in Harvard architecture, program memory and data memory is different. I will be discussed whenever I coming into the slide. Just I give a brief description about what is the 8051 and all. So first of all, I see the memory is twice. 8051 is faster. And you know, cost is less. These three is a very important thing. And another one is, you know, size. 8051 is smaller, means, you know, it is a embedded chip. So it can be used in anywhere. So small in size, you can say. And another thing is a very important thing is that everything that is like RAM, ROM, IO port, timer, counter, everything on the on chip itself. So the chip itself, it can be worked. No need the other peripheral ICs. That's the most and most important thing. So this is the major advantage of 8051 with respect to 8085. Another thing is that I want to, you know, share what is the disadvantage of 8051. Till today, we are using the processor. We are not using the controller. Till we are using the Pentium 4, Core i3, Core i4, something like that processor. Why it is the, you know, not replaced by a microcontroller till today? So some disadvantage obviously is there in 8051. What are the disadvantage? I am not changing the slide till now. I just, you know, teach you in a copy. I will be going into the slide one by one. One person is asking me the questions. That's why, sir, I'm just telling you. I'm just first I'm classing. I'm telling about.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
given 10-20 minutes, I will be first clarify what is the microcontroller and all, then I will be coming into the slide. So till now, I'm not going into the slide. So basically, this is the our main motto. What are the advantage? And next I am coming into the disadvantage. What are the disadvantage? You know, in 8051, that's a very, 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 you know, important things. What are the disadvantage of 8051? In processor, you know, in our computer, how many softwares is there? Maybe in your computer, sir, we have a 30 softwares. Maybe my computer have a 20 softwares. Maybe the different persons have a different software. Maybe 25, maybe 28, maybe 21, something like that. So if you are replaced by a controller, so then every program or every software, you need one controller. So means microprocessor is used for various job purpose, whereas microcontroller is used for dedicated job purpose. Microcontroller is used for various job purpose, whereas microprocessor is used only the dedicated job purpose. Remember, this thing is a very, 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 very important these things. So first thing you recall, that is the only the disadvantage, microprocessor is used for various job purpose. Means you maybe require 100 software, you can use only single processor. But if you require 100 software, means you require 100 microcontroller over here. Microcontroller is erasable, no issues for that. You can change the program, but not at a time two program, only one program can be run. That's the main funda of microcontroller. You should remember that only one program it can be run, so it's used for dedicated job purpose, not for various job purpose. Next one, you know, required in our subject, maybe, you know, it is a very silly question, but I am explaining because someone may not be in our, you know, maybe in the EC department or maybe the electrical department, maybe from the other background. So I am just explaining the one additions, whatever that you required in our microcontroller system, that is the hexadecimal addition. I'm just explain, then I coming into the topic. So first, you know, if I'm talking about the decimal number system, 78 plus 67, if I'm adding these two, so what will be the result? 8 plus 7 is nothing but a 15, 5 over here and 1 over here. How? Because you know the decimal number system base is 10. So 15 minus 10. So 5 will be put it over here. And 10 means 10 into how much? 1. This 1 coming here as a carry. So 6 plus 7, that is 13 plus 1, 14. So again, 14 minus 10. So 4 will be put it over here. And 10 means 10 into how much? 10 into 1. So 1 coming here as a carry. So 145 is the answer. In a decimal number system, whatever you do in every day. But you know, in a hexadecimal number system, say like AB plus CD, B means 11 and D means, you know, 13. So it will be coming around 24. A means 10, B means 11, and so on. F means 25. So B means 11 and D means 13. So together is 24. 24 minus 16. So it will be 8. 8 here, 8 will be coming over here. And 16 means 16 into how much? 1. 1 coming here as a carry. So 10 plus 12, that is 22 plus 1. 23. So 23 minus 16 again. So how much? 7. 7 will be put it over here. And 16 means 16 into how much? 1. 1 coming here as a carry. So 175 is the answer. This is the hexadecimal additions. This is the hexadecimal additions. I'm just talking about that hexadecimal subtraction. That is say a D2 minus 14. So what will be the subtraction? 2 means in a decimal number system, whenever we subtract as 2 minus 4, we are always doing like that, 2 assuming as a 12. But you know, over here, 2 you cannot assuming as a 12, 2 assuming as a 18. 2 assuming as a 12, why? Because the base of the number system in decimal is 10. That's why 2 plus 10. But over here, as a base is 16. So 16 plus 2, that is the 18. 18 minus 4, that is 14. 14 is nothing but a E. 14 is nothing but a E. So E will be put it over here. And D assuming as a C. So C minus 1. C minus 1 is nothing but a B. So BE is the result. B is full form Bachelor of Engineering. So without this subtraction, we are, you know, whenever I teach, I will be say the student that without this subtraction, you cannot become a Bachelor of Engineer. So this is a funny thing, just nothing else. D2 is nothing but assuming as 18, because the base of the number system is 16. So 16 plus 2 is 18. 18 minus 4 is equal to E. And you know, D assuming as a C. C minus 1 is equal to B. So that will be BE. Remember, you know, sometime we are converting into the decimal, then it will be converting into the decimal. Then we are subtract, then again coming into the hexadecimal. This procedure is not correct over here because we need several kind of addition and subtraction. So we will be go through this kind of procedures. And another two thing, which are not discussed yesterday also. So I will be discussed today after 4 o'clock. It will be missed yesterday. That is the 2's complement of a number, and you know, for binary, hex to binary, that is also required. So next we are coming into the slide. Next, this is our architecture. You know what is the microprocessor? I already discussed. These are the microcontroller. What is the microcontroller? I already discussed. RAM, ROM, all are internally. And this is the computer system. All are connected externally. All are connected externally. So, you know, these are the all are connected externally. Next. You know, if I'm talking about the microprocessor system, then RAM, ROM, IO port, timer, counter, all are connected externally. But if microcontroller, then all are in the chip itself. Then all are in the chip itself. That's the advantage of microcontroller. All are available in the chip itself. Next. This is the difference between microprocessor and microcontroller. I already discussed. You just read it. These are the applications of microcontroller. With the help of microcontroller, whatever you can do. Anything you can do using microcontroller, everything is possible. This is a RoboDog. These are the 4-bit microcontroller. Okay, these are the 4-bit microcontroller. These are the pin, these are the IO port, how many counter, RAM, ROM, features, etc. So we are talking about the 8-bit microcontroller, that is Intel. In Intel is nothing but 8051. These are the 8-bit microcontroller. How many pins are there? 40 pins. How many IO lines? 32 IO lines. There are 4 ports. 32 IO lines. 2 counter or 2 timer. 2 counter or 2 timer. 182 RAMs means, sir, you have a internal, you know, you have a maybe a total memory capacity. Our programming memory is 64K and your data memory is 64K. So program memory 64K and data memory 64K together is 128 kilobyte of memory. So 64 kilobyte program memory and 64 kilobyte data memory together is 128 kilobyte of memory, right? In 128 kilobyte, so this ROM 4K is used as a program memory. So you have a internally 4K. If you required, you can connect another 60K. You can connect another 60K. RAM is used as an internal data memory. Internal data memory. So you have already 128 byte, not kilobyte, 128 byte. So if you required, you can connect another externally 64K minus 128 byte. 64K minus 128 byte. 64K minus 128 byte RAM you can be extend or you can be connect. Some microcontroller in 8051 series, there are several microcontroller is there. Some microcontroller its internal memory is 8K. Internal memory is 8K, maybe 128 is nothing but a 256 or something like that. So every 51, maybe some memory, maybe changes, maybe increased, maybe decreased. So that's why if I'm talking about the what are the requirement, as per the requirement, we can change our the IC name. How the IC name is there, I will be coming into later on. But you ROM is nothing but a 4K, which is a completely internal ROM. RAM is nothing but a 128, which also internal. But if you require, you can connect externally. Total memory capacity is 128 kilobyte of memory, total extendable memory, right? These are the other ICs is there. Next, coming into the second part, there is a 16-bit of microcontroller. And this is von Neumann architecture, Harvard architecture, and modified Harvard architecture. And what is the, you know, von Neumann architecture? What is the Harvard architecture? I'm just discussing about it. Von Neumann architecture, if I'm talking about, this is the von Neumann architecture, where is program memory and data memory is, you know, same locations. And Harvard architecture, where is the program memory and data memory is different. One part is the program memory, another part is the data memory. So, you know, if program memory and data memory in the same, so you, it is called von Neumann architecture, and Harvard architecture is nothing but a program memory and data memory is separate. This is the instruction set I will be discuss. This is the main architecture of 8051. Just, you know, you see very carefully. I think it will be help a lot. And next, first I'm starting from this, you know, these blocks. In 8051, there are internally interrupt controller it's have. In everywhere, you know, 8085, in 8086, or any processor, we are connected the internal interrupt controller externally. Interrupt controller externally, but it will be available on our chip itself. So how many interrupts is coming? You know, three interrupts are internal interrupt. All three interrupt are internal interrupt, which is coming from the ROM, is called three interrupt is from internal interrupt. Two are coming from the external interrupt. Two are coming from the external interrupt. Out of these five interrupt, only one interrupt are sending into the CPU. Only one interrupt are sending into the CPU. Three interrupt from the internal, two external, and out of five interrupt, only one interrupt are sending into the CPU. If you required more than the five interrupt, then you can connect a interrupt controller or something like that. But you have three plus two, that is a five interrupt. Remember, three is an internal interrupt and two is external interrupt. Together is five interrupt. And only one interrupt are sending into the CPU. That is the function of interrupt controller. Depend upon the priority and everything, we are sending only one interrupt into the CPU. That is the function of interrupt controller. And next is the program ROM, or, you know, program memory, whatever you can say. This 4K, you know, available in the on chip itself. If you require, you can connect externally. If you require, you can connect externally. But remember, 4K ROM available on the chip itself. Just see the everywhere, you can see the both ended arrow means bidirectional bus is connected. If I'm talking about RAM, bidirectional bus is connected. If I'm talking about the, you know, timer counter, bidirectional bus is connected. Everywhere bidirectional bus is connected, but only ROM, you know, nothing but is read only memory. That's why arrow is only the downwards, means only the one way arrow is given, nothing else. 128 bytes RAM, it is it completely depend upon the data RAM, data memory, or you can say. So you have a 128 bytes. If you want extend, you can extend up to 64 kilobyte. That is the functions. And what are the internal RAM? What is the available in the internal RAM? I will be coming later on. The two day sessions, there will be internal, we will be talking about the internal RAM, etc. And two timer or two counter. Two timer or two counter means one is timer zero, another is called timer one. Timer zero and timer one is nothing but a timer counter. Timer operations and counter operations. So if I'm talking about the timer operations and counter operations, 16-bit timer operations, 16-bit timer or counter operations, nothing else. What are the functions of timer and what are the functions of counter? It's a very, you know, very interesting things. Say you give a punishment to a students that you go to the downstairs 200 and you coming 200 upstairs. So downstairs 200 and upstairs 200. Who will be counted? You given to the another student that you count that whether he or she will going 200 downwards or not. First count the 200 and then you count the upward 200. So these fellow, those are nothing but a counting. That will be depend upon the person who is just nothing but a going towards, you know, down towards the 200 step and upwards 200 step. So it's remember, it's not depend upon the particular person who is counting. It will be depend upon the particular person who is doing the work. So that is the function, you know, count the external clock pulses, then it's called counter. Whenever count the internal clock pulses, then it's called timer. Means, say, you say to a student that you count from 0 to 100. So they, he or she may be count 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, something like that. So you know he will be counting according to his speed, not depend upon the any other persons. That is nothing but a call timer. Whenever count the internal clock pulse, which is generated by our crystal oscillator, it's called timer. And whenever you know counting the external clock pulse, then it's called counter. That is the difference. And you know, it's a timer 0 and timer 1. It's a there are two timers. One is timer 0, another is timer 1. Maybe it's called timer 0, maybe it's called timer 1. Depend upon the functions, we are talking about the timer or counter. Next one, full duplex. What is a full duplex? You know, there are three procedures. One is a simplex, one is a half duplex, one is a full duplex. Simplex means only one-way communications like TV. Half duplex communication is nothing but a whenever you transmit, you cannot receive like a walkie-talkie. And full duplex communication, now this communication is nothing but a full duplex communications. Anyone, any time you can say, I can say, both can say. So that's why it's nothing but a full duplex communications. That is. So UART is nothing but a use for full duplex serial communication, where TXD is used for transmission and RXD used for reception. TXD used for transmission and RXD used for reception. That is the function of UART. Full form, universal asynchronous receiver and transmit. Universal asynchronous receiver and transmit. Next is IO port, four IO port. There is a four IO port, P0, P2, P1, and P3. Four IO ports. And each are 8-bit wide. Each are 8-bit wide. So four IO port, you know, you have a P0, P2, P1, and P3. Each 8-bit wide. So together 32 IO lines are available. Together 32 IO lines are available. First P0, then P2, then P1, and then P3. Four IO port, each are 8-bit wide. Each are 8-bit wide. 8-bit wide means, each are 8-bit wide means 4 into 8, that is 32 IO lines. Whereas, why sir P0 after that P2? So it is nothing but a sir, P0 and P2 is used for address public databases. RACE2 may be used as a input output device and other functions, but P0 and P2 used as a input output operation as well as address public databases. Whenever I discuss the, you know, pin configurations, I will be discussed in a vast way. Another is bus controller. Bus controller is nothing but which is control all the buses. That is the function of bus controller. And 8-bit CPU optimization for process control. 8-bit CPU is there to control everything. This is just like a brain of a human being. An oscillation circuit which is using to create the, you know, nothing but a clock. And this crystal is nothing but a connected with a oscillation circuit which is used to nothing but a generate the clock. That is the function of whole functions of 8051. Rather than that, we have some SFR registers called special functions registers. Those I will be discussed later on. Just I given the brief name. These are the features. You just read one by one by your home. There is no issues for that. It's a very simple. Remember, there are two registers is there. One is called A and another is called B, which is both are 8-bit registers. A is 8-bit accumulator. A is 8-bit accumulator. Any arithmetical logical operations without accumulator is not possible. If you want to add two numbers, always one is a compulsory is A, another will be the different. So A is nothing but a, you call accumulator. It's a special function of registers. You know, every time we are using, maximum time we are using the accumulator. Next, B is used only for the multiplication and divisions, nothing else. Only multiplications and division operations, B registers is used. So B register is used basically to store the data as a general purpose register or multiplication or divisions operation, nothing else. After multiplications, if result is 16-bit, then higher 8-bit will be stored into the B registers and lower 8-bit result will be stored into the accumulator. So if result A and B multiply after multiplier A and B, if result is 16-bit, so lower 8-bit will be accumulator, higher 8-bit into the B register. That is the function of B. And after the, whenever it divisions, you know, remainder part will be stored into the B register. That is the function of B registers. PC is a very important register. That is the program counter. The instruction to be executed, the instruction to be executed, the address of the instruction stored into the PC, that is the function of program counter. The instruction to be executed, that the address of the instruction will be stored into the PC, that is the function of program counter. Whenever any instruction is executed, the next instruction, where is it written, what are the address, in that particular address, you know, it will be stored. Yes, it will be everywhere. It is same. It is a 5-1 family member. In 5-1 family member, whatever I am talking about, everything is same. Next is DPTR. DPTR is nothing but a DPH and DPL. You know, there is only one 16-bit register which is point a memory location. It's called DPTR. It's a 16-bit register which is point any kind of internal RAM, internal ROM, which is a program ROM or external memory locations, whatever it is. 16-bit address, if you want to point out or you want to get a data, then DPTR is always used because only one 16-bit register is there, that is the DPTR. It's also is a two-part DPTR. One is called DPH. Higher byte of DPTR is called DPH, and lower byte of DPTR is called DPL. Is named DPL and DPH. H for high and L for low. So DPTR higher 8-bit. It is a two 8-bit register together is called DPTR. So that is the function of DPTR. Next, PSW is there, is nothing but a used to just like a flag register of 8085, which is nothing but a used as a status flag. It is used to, you know, whether any arithmetical operations, after any arithmetical operation, maybe any flag is set or reset, something like that. So PSW is a very, very, very much important program status word. Next is, sir, those are the nothing but, you know, SFR register, IE interrupt enable, IP interrupt priority, PCON power controls, SBUF serial buffer, SCON serial control, TCON timer control, TMOD timer mode, IL TH0 and TL0 is called together timer 0. TH1 and TL1 together called timer 1. So those are the nothing but SFR register. I will be discussed later on one by one. But this is just name I want to given to you. SFR is nothing but a special function registers, right? There are, I remember, four register also is there for a port 0, port 1, port 2, port 3. Just called, you can say, as a buffer register or something like that. So it will be stored the content of port 0. Next, sir, is another is that we have a bank 0, bank 1, bank 2, bank 3 is a very important thing. Bank 0, bank 1, bank 2, bank 3. It's very, very important. We have a four different bank. We have a four different bank. In four different bank, you can select any kind of bank. Every bank will be have 8 register. Every bank will have a 8 register. So how many registers in 8051 for bank? For bank 08 register, for bank 18 register, bank 28 register, bank 38 register. So 8 plus 8 plus 8 plus 8. So 4 into 8, that is 32 registers are available. It's called bank registers. Means you have R0 to R7, 4. Means we have a 32 registers of 8-bit. 8-bit, 32 registers we have. It is the functions of bank. I will be discussed later on whenever I discuss the internal RAM. Next, this is another architecture, and this you just see ROM 4 kilobyte, RAM 128 byte, timer 2, IO pin 32, serial port 1. But you know, you see that is the interrupt is 6, but I am telling about the 5, because 3 internal, 2 external, so 5 interrupt. How 6 interrupt will be coming? Reset also a interrupt. Reset means whenever microcontroller is reset. Reset means maybe a microcontroller maybe hang, so you can restart just like a computer. You are restart, so restart like that. There is a reset pin is there. What is the function of reset? I will be discussed whenever I discuss the pin configurations. But reset, there is another interrupt, so total is a 6 interrupt. There is a comparison between 8051, 8052, and 8031. So if I'm compared with 8051, 8052, and 8031, so if you see that ROM is 4K, 8052 8K, and 8031 is 0K. So if I'm talking about the RAM 128 and 256, the timer, you know, timer is nothing but a two timer. And in 8052, that is a 3 timer, IO pins, 32 IO pins in everywhere. You know, serial port, there are one serial port. And you know, in 80 interrupt source, 6 interrupt source in 8051 and 8052, it is a, 8. So if I'm talking about the 8051, so we have 6, interrupt sources. And if I'm talking about the 8052, it is a higher version of 8051. So it will be near about 2 another interrupt. Yes, reset also is a interrupt. It's a, you can say, is a highest priority interrupt. It's called as a highest priority interrupt. And you know, as a timer, you increase every timer have another interrupt. So as a three interrupt, so three timers, so it is another increase. Another one thing is there. So it have a eight interrupt. It has a sixth interrupt. So I discuss later on whenever I discuss the interrupt portions. These are the 5-1 family member. Several ICs is there, not you know, near about more than 1,000 ICs there in 5-1 family. Any IC you can purchase, same programming language in everywhere, it can be done. Same programming language, no issues, no other instruction. Every you know, 5-1 family member, every ICs have a same instruction set, so you can write the program same, no issue. These are the 5-1 family member. These are the pin configuration, very interesting things. Pin configuration, what are the function of each pins? So if I'm talking about the pins, just see, there are four port. As I'm talking about in architecture, port 0, P0 to P7, port 1, P10 to P17, port 2, P2.0 to P2.7, and port 3, P3.0 to P3.7. These are the four ports. Together is 32 lines, whatever I discuss. 1 pin to 8 pin port 1, you know, 11 pin to 17 pin is port 3, and you know, 21 pin to 28 pin is port 2, and you know, 32 pin to 39 pin is port 0. Together 32 lines. Function of is IO port. First function is nothing but an input and output operations. Is the first function, that is the input and output operation is done. So that is the first function. So it is nothing but a you know, function is nothing but a port 0, port 1, port 2, port 3, all the functions basically same. The first function and the prime function is nothing but input output operations. You know, rather than input output operations, some other functions is also there. Those are nothing but a you know, just like for this port 0, it's used as a address / data bus multiplex. What does it multiplex is nothing but a, you know, it will be sometime act as a address bus. Just see the name A and D. AD0 means it is A0 plus D0 is created as a AD0, means it will be act as a address bus, act as a data bus. Sometime it will be act as a address bus, sometime it will be act as a data bus. Just see, you know, just see. Just see my copy. I'm just explain address bus, whatever we have. Just see my copy. A0 to A15. How many address bus? Address bus is 16 bit. So A0 to A15. It will be dividing into the two part. One is called A0 to A7. Another is called A8 to A15. This A0 to A7 means lower order address bus and data bus D0 to D7 are combined together and create AD0 to AD7. Means these buses sometime act as a address bus, sometime act as a data bus. These buses sometime act as a address bus, sometime act as a data bus. So we have a 8-bit data bus, so you know, 8-bit data bus and 8-bit address bus are multiplexed together and create AD0 to AD7. This AD0 to AD7 is nothing but a used as a, you know, used in port 0. So port 0 also have a different function, input output port as well as address / data bus multiplex. That is a function of port 0. Port 0 have an input output port as well as address / data bus multiplex. Next one, very important thing is that, that is the in port zero, every port not required, but port zero only required, that is the pull-up resistance. Pull-up resistance means, you know, another extra voltage are given through through port zero, which is nothing but operate any circuit. Every port have a internally pull-up resistance, but in a port zero, we are given externally pull-up resistance. So what are the pull-up resistance and how it will be connected? I will be shown you later on, but you just see, you just listen, that is the port zero have a external pull-up resistance, whereas other, you know, port one, port two, port three, all are internally pull-up resistance. Next, my prime questions is that, you know, so what are the pull-up resistance and what are the, it's, you know, if explain. So pull-up resistance, just like a, say, in, you know, maybe in a lockdown situations, I cannot walk and I want to go to hospital, but how I can go? Because there is a, you know, there is a no car facilities is there, and you know, no ambulance may not be available. So if, you know, any persons like you, sir, you are helping me to go to hospital. So I just taking your help and I'm go to hospital. So in between, you know, in between, maybe the you are give me a help and I want to go, then I can, it can be possible to go into the, you know, hospital. Otherwise is not possible, because what are the problem in the other, in the, you know, other things, that if I don't want to go, you cannot carry me. If you want to help and I want to go, then it's possible, I will be supposed to go to the hospital, and it's the possibilities. So that's why, you know, pull-up resistance given a particular voltage and port also given a voltage, then any circuit can be working. How it will be work, you know, how the pull-up resistance is connected, I will be shown in later on, but I will be discussed before that the other port. Like port 2. Port 2 is nothing but a P2.0 to P2.7. Here is nothing but 8 to a 15. Those are the nothing but a higher order address bus. Those are the nothing but a higher order address bus. And port 2 is nothing but used as a, you know, input-output port as well as higher order address bus. That is the function of port 2. And port 1 is used only input-output operations. That is P1.0 to P1.7 is used only for the input-output operations. Nothing else, only used for the input-output operations. Number 3, port 3 is a very, very important thing, is that only input-output port as well as some other operations. Other operations is nothing but over here. It's mentioning that is the other operations. What are the other operations? First, RxD and TxD. In architecture, we see that there are two pins, is called TXD and RXD, which is used in a, you know, serial communication, that is the UART. TXD is used for transmission and RXD used for receptions. So that is the function of TXD and RXD. So what are the functions? TXD is for transmission and RXD used for receptions. So that is the function of TXD and RXD. That is the function of TXD and RXD. So P3.0 and P3.1 is used for serial communication, transmission and receptions. Next, sir, there are two external interrupt. I already told to you, that is one is INT0 and another is INT1. Two external interrupt, INT0 and INT1. Two external interrupt which is coming into the microcontroller through INT0 and INT1. What are the function of TXD? TXD is nothing but a transmission, means the data are passing through this. The data are passing through this. What are the function of RxD? RxD data received through this. And interrupt, all are nothing but enter into the microcontroller. All are nothing but enter into the microcontroller. Means all are input. All are input, nothing else. Next, T0 and T1. What are the functions of T0 and T1? That it's also is very, very important, T0 and T1. We are already told we have a two timer or two counter. Whenever the counter operations, you are nothing but a connecting the external clock pulse, just like that. Which is connected with a T0 or T1. So basically, you know, clock pulse connected with T0 and T1, which is used to count the clock pulse. So count in counter operation through T0 and T1, microcontroller receive the clock pulse. Microcontroller will be receive the clock pulse. That is the function of T0 and T1. T0 is used for timer counter 0 and T1 is used for counter 1. And read and write is nothing but a whenever microcontroller read or write, corresponding signal will be goes low. These are the 32 pins I already discussed. Next 8 pin I will be discussing. Point number 20, pin number 20, that is the ground connected with the ground. Pin number 40 connected with plus 5 volt. Next 34 is done. Another 6 is left. XTEL 1 and XTEL 2 is a very two important, you know, pins. There we are connecting these two pin with a connecting with a crystal. We are connecting with either 11.0592 megahertz crystal. So we are connecting the crystal with 8051 through this pin. Say maybe you don't have any kind of crystal, but you know lockdown situations, you cannot procure the crystal also. Then you, if you have the function generator where you know given the clock. So if you have the function generator, so XTEL 1 will be connected with a function generator or other oscillation circuit, and XTEL 2 will be no connections. There is no connection of XTEL 2. That is the function of XTEL 1 and XTEL 2. How the circuit will be working, I will be shown to you. Reset, that is the RST. I already say that reset is the highest priority interrupt, or you can say this is an interrupt. So RST is nothing but a reset. Whenever a high signal are entered into the pin number 9, means a 5 volt are entered into the pin number 9, then microcontroller will be reset. Remember, in reset condition, all the pins of microcontroller will be reset, means all the registers will be reset. Reset means all the registers will be become zero. But only one register, that is the stack pointer, will be 0007. Only one register, that is a stack pointer, is 0007. But my question is that why 0007? Means what are the significant of that stack pointer is 0007. I will be discussed later on whenever I discuss the internal RAM. But you just remember one thing, all the registers like program status word, like accumulator, every registers will be become 0000H, but or 00H, whatever it is, but stack pointer is 07H. Remember why it is 07H. I will be discussed later on. Next pin is that 3 pin is left, that is 29, 30 and 31. These 3 is a very, 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 very important thing. That is, what are the function of 29, what are the function of 30 and what are the function of 31. PSEN is nothing but a program store enable. Program store enable, full form is program store enable. As we know, we have a two kinds of memory. One is a program memory and another is a data memory. One is a program memory and another is a data memory. If I'm talking about the program memory, then you can see that program memory is nothing but a connected with a PSEN. Program memory is connected with a PSEN. Means to distinguish between program memory and data memory, PSEN is used. So PSEN is basically used for program memory itself. But for data memory, we are not using the program memory. We are using read bar and write bar, etc. So PSEN basically used for program memory. So remember, for program memory, we are using the PSEN, but data memory, we are not using the PSEN. Whenever we are going into the memory interfacing today, in the second half, we are entering into the memory interfacing. In that particular cases, you will be understood what are the function of PSEN. That is the program store enable. Next, ALE / PROG. What are the functions of ALE and PROG? Full form is address latch enable, and PROG is nothing but a program. You know, everything, every person, as we have a two different, you know, mode. One is a programming mode, whenever we burn the program, whenever we write the program over here, and whenever we are execute. Now my execution mode is on, so I am executing this. So every person have a two mode. So as a thing, microcontroller have a two mode. One is nothing but a whenever write the program into the microcontroller is called programming mode, and EEPROM programming or something like that. And another one is whenever after burn the program, you are connecting this IC into the circuit, that is called execution mode. So programming mode and execution mode, this PROG and VVV is basically used for programming mode, EEPROM programming mode. At the time of EEPROM program, it is used. And you know, whenever VPP also the same. So PROG is nothing but a programming, is nothing but a used as a 50 millisecond pulse we are given. We are given a 50 millisecond pulse so that the microcontroller can understood that the program will be burned into the microcontroller. It is the function of PROG. And ALE is nothing but a use to distinguish between address bus and data bus. ALE is used for distinguish between address bus and data bus. Nothing else. Next is EA bar oblique VPP is a very, very important EA bar oblique VPP. The very important whenever we do any kind of project will be understood, will be, you know, this function will be help a lot. We have an internal memory of 4K. We have an internal memory of 4K, that is the 4K ROM. What are the 4K ROM, sir? It's used either in programming ROM. It's used only for the programming ROM. So we can write the program into the, you know, 4K memory. So your program may be, you know, big in size. Maybe not possible to complete your program within the 4K memory location. So you need maybe the higher memory. So maybe you required 6K memory. Maybe you required 6K memory. 6K memory you required. So how it will be done? There are two procedures. Either you used 4K internal, 2K external. Either you used 4K internal, 2K external, or you connect 6K externally. Or you can connect 6K externally. I am repeat once again. There are two procedure. One procedure is that 4K internal plus 2K external. Or you can connect externally 6K memory where you write the program and it will be connected with the IC. So if your program below 4K, so there is no problem at all. Your program can be burned into the microcontroller. Or if your program is a higher, then your maybe 4K internal, then external memory, or connected the external memory. So first two cases, either your program within the 4K, or first internal, then external, then EA bar should be connected with a plus 5 volt. Then EA bar, EA full form is external access. EA bar full form is external access. So this EA bar connected with plus 5 volt. But whenever your program will be execute from the external memory. External memory means, sir, your program will be connected with the external memory. Means, sir, your program will be burned in a particular, you know, memory locations or in a memory chip, and that will be connected with the microcontroller. Then, whenever your total program you burn into the another chip, that is a 6K externally chip, then EA bar should be connected with a ground. EA bar should be connected with the ground. That is the function of EA bar. Next, I coming into the VPP, voltage peak to peak. It is the function, you know, whenever at the time of EEPROM programming, at the time of EEPROM programming, VPP connected with plus 21 volt. VPP connected with a plus 21 volt. That is the function of VPP. You know, VPP connected with a plus 21 volt. So next, so every pin is, I think, discussed. So I just go through the functions. What are the pin I already mentioned? Just those are the written over here. Those are the written over here. VPP is nothing but a connected with 21 volt. PROG is nothing but a connected with a 50 millisecond pulse at the time of EEPROM programming. PSEN is program store enable. You will be already got this kind of slide, so you will be, no, may not be right to read, you know, write anything. You can read it, it will be available to you. I already given to you. So XTEL 1 and XTEL 2 connected with a crystal. This is a connected with a crystal, and there is a two capacitor, that is a 33 PF capacitor is there, or 3250 picofarad, any capacitor you can connect. If you are connected a crystal, if you are connected a external oscillator, or you know you have function generator, then XTEL 1 connected and XTEL 2 will be no connection. That is the functions. That is the how to crystal is connected. This is a reset circuit. This reset circuit we are always used, you know, our project. This circuit will be we are drawn in our project, whenever we do a project, whenever student will be do the project, mini project, micro project, any project using microcontroller, this circuit should be drawn. As you just see, EA bar oblique VPP connected with, you know, plus 5 volt. VCC is nothing but a plus 5 volt. As we are assuming that our program is within the 4K, because, in the, you know, maximum time your program may not be greater than the 4K. 4K is a big program, near about 4000 line program you can write. So if you write carefully, so your program may be within that. no issues. So that's why, you know, the chip producer, you know, Intel or something like that, those are people are doing this kind of chip, you know, manufacture this kind of kit, chip. Those are not given the more than 4K, because maximum program within the 4K. So that's why it's not required to more than the 4K. So that's why 4K memory is given internally. Otherwise, chip cost will be increased. And it's nothing but a wasted of money, nothing else. So next is nothing but a 8.2K. 8.2K, there is a resistance which is connected with the ground. So whenever this is a tag switch, whenever you are, or a push button switch, whatever you say, whenever you push this switch, this 5 volt are enter into the reset pin. In 5 volt enter into the reset pin and microcontroller will be reset. What is the reset and what are the functions of reset? Say you may be a design a, you know, using a LCD, you are designing a menu card for your hostel. Maybe your college, maybe a hostel. In hostel, in every day there is a separate menu. So every day it will be display the menu. Lunch, dinner, every menu you are written a program and that will be shown. Maybe whenever you are director or something like that, enter into the college, maybe in that particular time, your menu on the your suites. So you want to see the menu from the beginning. So how it's possible? You reset. Your program will be start from the beginning. So your menu will be coming from beginning. Means it will be from rise and everything one by one, one by one. So your director or your principal will be see the menu. Means reset means nothing but the program will be starting from the beginning, nothing else. So you see every register at the reset condition is zero. Every register of the reset condition is zero. Only stack pointer is 07H. Only stack pointer is 07H. Why? I will be discussed later on. It's clear? So I am just going into the next slide. There are four ports. All port bit addressable. Any bit you can access. Bit addressable is a very important thing in 8085. Whenever you need the data, you will be need the data 8-bit wise. Not you cannot check any particular single bit. So if you need a single bit, you cannot. So in 8051, it's possible all the bit and bit addressable. You can access any kind of bit. This is a port zero. This is the P0. It's called a pull-up resistance. This pull-up resistance is nothing but we are given a plus 5 volt with a 10K resistance. Every pins are connected with a 10K resistance with plus 5 volt. Then any circuit can be operated over here. Otherwise, it's not possible. That's why we are given a pull-up resistance in port 0. By default, all the ports internally pull-up resistance, but port 0 is not possible because it will be work as a multiplex addressable data lines. That's why it's not possible to give the internal pull-up resistance. If you require, you can connect externally. This is a P1 and P2. This is a P3. Different function. I already discussed those functions. RxD, TxD, INT0, INT1, T0, T1, everything I discuss. A and B registers. Register some registers. A and B register, what are the functions? You just see A is for accumulator, any arithmetical multiplications, divisions, everything, operations, addition, subtraction, all are done through A. B is used only for the multiplication and divisions and data storage and maybe stored, nothing else, only the three functions. This is the PC program counter and DPTR used to hold the address of a memory. Both two are 16-bit register. PC, there is a no address, but DPTR, there are two, dividing into the two part, DVH and DPL, which will be available in SFR registers. This is the PSW. What are the function of PSW? That is the program status word. This is the function of PSW, program status word. So program status word, if I'm talking about program status word. What are the function of program status word? Just see, if I'm talking about AB plus CD, what will be happened? result is I already discussed 178. Today morning we have discussed if carry generated in lower nibble means this 2 bit carry generated in lower nibble that will be passes into the higher nibble, then auxiliary carry flag will be set, then AC flag will be set. I'm repeat once again, if carry generated in lower nibble, nibble means 4 bit, if carry generated in lower nibble that will be passed into the higher nibble, then auxiliary carry flag will be set. If carry generated in that particular bit, it will be passed into that particular bit, then auxiliary carry flag will be set, that is the AC. If carry or borrow generated in any arithmetical logical operation, then carry flag will be set. Next, F0. Till now we are discuss about the general purpose register. This is the first time we are discuss about the general purpose flag bit. General purpose flag bit, what does it mean? It mean that it can be stored any particular bit. A register can store 8 bit or 16 bit, depend upon their size. But this F0 is used for basically to store any particular bit. Bit means either 0 or 1. You can store any particular bit in F0. That is the function of F0. General purpose flag bit. RS0 and RS1, these two is used for the bank selection. These two are used for the bank selection. RS0 and RS1 depend upon these two. Maybe bank 0, bank 1, bank 2, bank 3 will be selected. Maybe bank 0, bank 1, bank 2, bank 3 will be selected. Next, OV, full form is overflow flag. OV is full form is overflow flag. So, you know, overflow, this, you know, for overflow, this flag may be set or reset. How works overflow and what are the bank selection? As already we discussed, you know, there are 4 banks. You know, bank 0, bank 1, bank 2, bank 3, and each bank have 8 register. To select the bank, RS0 and RS1 is used. 00, bank 0, 01, bank 1, 010, bank 2, 11, bank 3. Here you can say the 4 bank will be selected. Say you just see my copy. Say we have 7F in an accumulator. 7F in accumulator. What are the binary? If you are converting to the binary, then 0111 and 1111. That this first 0 is nothing but this number is positive number. If I increased by 1, means I plus 1 with respect to accumulator, what will be happen? Accumulator will be becomes 80. What are the binary? 1000. 0000. So this is 1, most significant bit is 1, means if the number is negative, number is negative. So if result greater than the 7 bit in 8 bit operation, then it will be effect, most significant bit, MSB bit, then overflow flag will be set, then OV flag will be set, then OV flag will be set. That is the function of overflow. Next question is the next flag bit is that there is a parity bit. Parity is a very simple thing is that if the content of accumulator, have odd number of 1, then parity flag will be set. Remember the result means say after the addition 178 is the result, but you know result is nothing but a 78, but 1 is a carry. So you know in 78 how many 1s are there? If it is an odd number of 1, then how many 1s, sir, over here? 78 means 0111, 8 means 1000. How many 1s? 4. It's an even number. If it is an odd, maybe, you know, 5 number of 1, that is an odd number, then parity flag will be set. So parity flag is set only odd number of 1, nothing else. Next, sir. These are the function of flag register I already discussed. These are the, you know, RS0 and RS1. So basically 00 bank 0, 01 bank 1, 00 bank 0, 0001 bank 1, 10 bank 2, and 11 bank 3. So you select the bank, we are using those kind of things, right? Next, remember PSW.3 and PSW.4. That is the value of RS0 is nothing but a PSW.3 and RS1 PSW.4. It's a very important one. With the help of this PSW.3 and PSW.4, we are selecting the bank. How we are selecting the bank, I will be discussing. Remember, RS0 is nothing but a PSW.3 and RS1 is nothing but a PSW.4. And these are the locations I will be discussing how it will be done. Just coming into this program. This program, forget about the instruction because I not till you know explain what are the instructions available in 8051. So I will not explain this program and all. Just you assuming 38 plus 2F, which flag means carry flag and auxiliary flag and parity flag, which bit is set and which bit it is reset. And next 9C plus 64, which flag is set and which flag is reset. You can do it. 38 plus 2F, what will be the result? 38 plus 2F, you can see my copy. 38 plus 2F, 8 means, and F means 15 plus 8 is nothing but a 23. 23 minus 16. So result is 7. F means 15 plus 8 means 8. Means 15 plus 8, 23. 23 minus 16 because base 16. So 7. 7 will be put it over here. Right? So 1 is a carry as 16 means 16 into how much? 1. So 1 coming here as a carry. 3 plus 2 plus 1, that is a 6. 67 is the result. Sir, carry generated in lower nibble? Yes, sir. So that's why auxiliary carry flag is equal to 1. Sir, carry generated? No, sir. So carry flag will be 0. Next, sir, convert it into the, you know, binary. 0110. 0111. How many ones? 3 plus 2. That is 5. 5 ones. That is the odd number. So parity flag will be 1. So 1. Auxiliary carry flag 1. Carry flag 0. 0 means reset. And 1 means set. So next program is 9C plus 64. What are the functions? C means 12 plus 4 means 4. 12 plus 4 means 16. 12 plus 4 means 16. So 16 minus 16. How much? 0. So 16 means 16 into how much? 1. 1 is a carry. 10 plus 1, 16. 10 plus 9 plus 1, 10 plus 6, 16. So 16 minus 16 again, 0. Carry 1. So 100 result. 100 is the result. So, sir, auxiliary carry flag is set. Carry generated in these two. Answer is yes. So, auxiliary carry flag will be set. Sir, carry is generated. Yes, sir. Because one is coming, which is carry. So, carry flag will be 1. Right? Next, auxiliary carry flag. Sir, what will be the result? Result is 00. Not 100. Result is 00, which is available in accumulator. So convert into the binary. 0000, 0000. How many ones? No ones. Zero ones. So not a odd number. So parity flag will be 0. parity flag will be zero as the result is 00, result not a 100. If you are calculating using 100, then parity flag will be set. So it will be wrong. So we are calculating with 00 as the content of accumulator is 00. So next, internal RAM. So before internal RAM, I want to give a lecture on copy because it will be very much helpful to you if you understood copy. Yesterday is not possible because maybe, 100 participation, I am not entering. Another mobile phone also are not entering. You know, we are talking about the, nowadays we are talking about the digital teaching. Now I am using, the two, one is the mobile phone, one is the laptop. Mobile phone is basically used for copy, and laptop is used for nothing but one thing is that is a laptop is used for your slide and whatever I say, and a mobile phone uses for the copy. It is a fixed. You can doing the same kind of things as we don't have any kind of instrument because we don't have mobile stand and everything because suddenly lockdown. So how I can procure? I don't have any kind of things, and how I'm established this kind of mobile phone, how setting this mobile phone, I explain later on. Whenever my class is over, I just see my total structure, how it is doing. So just see internal RAM. So internal RAM is 128 byte means 0 to 127. So it will be becomes 128. 0 means hexadecimal 00H. 127 is nothing but a 7FH. So 00H to 7FH is our internal RAM. 00H to 7FH is our internal RAM. Just see the structure. These are the four bank is starting in the beginning. Just see, this is R0, this is R1, this is R2, R3, R4, R5, R6, R7. Everywhere the same, R0 to R7, R0 to R7, R0 to R7. In between, maybe this is the R3. Everywhere the same. So, how many R0 resistance is there? 4. How many R1 resistance is there? 4. How many R2 register is there? 4. Every register, 4. So, this is nothing but a for bank 3. This one is stand for bank 3. This one is stand for bank 3. This one is stand for bank 2. This one is stand for bank 1. And the last one is stand for bank 0. Bank, B-A-N-K, bank. Everywhere, bank 1, bank 3, bank 2, bank 1, and bank 0. 4 bank is there. Sir, how many locations is there? It is starting from 00H. Ending at 07H. It is starting at 08H. Ending at 0FH. It is starting at 10H. Ending at 17H. Starting at 18H. Ending at 1FH. So it's starting from 00H and ending at 1FH. Recall, it's starting from 00H and ending at 1F. 1F is nothing but a 31. 1F in decimal is nothing but a 31. 00 to 31, it will be 32. So this 32 is nothing but a reserve for bank. Bank 0, bank 1, bank 2, and bank 3. So now question is that, sir, what are the RAM locations of R4? It's for 00,
it's for 01, it's for 02, it's for 03, it's for 04. So bank 4 is R4 is nothing but a R4 of bank 0. R4 of bank 0 is nothing but a 04H. R5 is 05H. R6 is 06H. And R7 is 07H. Sir, for R4 of bank 1, R4 of bank 1, 08H for R0, 09, 0A, 0B, 0C. So R4 of bank, R4 of, you know, bank 1 is 0CH. It's clear? Any doubts if you have, you can ask. So every, you know, register have a separate locations. You can denote by their locations also. Any queries in this bank? Okay, ma'am. So I will be proceed to, you know, next, that is from after 1F, it will be 20 to 2F. 20 to 2F. This location is called bit addressable area. Bit addressable area. What is a bit addressable area? I will be discussed later on, and how it will be worked, I will be discussed later on. But I just discussed in the topmost 3F. Sorry, 30. After 2F, it will be 30. After 2F, it will be 30. Because you know, in decimal, after 19, it will be 20. After 29, it will be 30. So after 2F, in hexadecimal, it will be 30. So 302 7F. This area is called byte addressable. This area is called byte addressable area. So 30 to 7F is byte addressable area. 20 to 2F is a bit addressable area. After 7F means after internal RAM, there something is there, which is also is internal, is nothing but a SFR. But we are assuming as a, this is not an internal, because we are saying already internal RAM is, you know, 128. Whenever we are write the instruction, we are using the MOVX instruction, MOVX. So SFR is nothing but a special function register. What are the special function registers? I will be discussed later on. What are the special function registers? I will be discussed later on. It will be from 802FF. But before that, I want to discuss 2022F is called bit addressable area. Just see when from 20 to 2F is called bit addressable area, 30 to 7F is called byte addressable area. Byte addressable area, same, or user area or scratch pad, whatever you say, it is the same as 8085, any memory locations, whatever you want, you can copy a particular byte. If you want to change, you change the particular byte. If you want to, you know, delete, you can delete every byte, means total bytes. Next, just see, next I'm explaining. See, it's nothing but a bit addressable area. What is the bit addressable area? Two zero to 2F is a bit addressable area. Similarly, next 21 and so on. So there are 8. Every memory location can store 8-bit data. Today morning I discussed every memory locations can store 8-bit data, not more than that. So this 20 to 2F is called, this 20 to 2F is called byte address. And you know, this is, say I'm talking about the, this is D0, this is D1, so this will be D7. So every memory locations, how many bits? Every memory locations have D0 to D7, means 8-bit. every memory locations have 8 bit. So how many bits are there? 20 to 2F. How many locations is there? 0 to F means 16 locations. So 16 locations into 8 bit. So how many? It will be 128. So again, if I am talking about 002, 127, so it will be 00H to 7FH. So 128 bit address over there. This address is called bit address. This address is called bit address. It is starting from 00, 01, 02, 03, 04, 05, 06, and 07. And you know, next 08, as so on and so forth. Last it will be 7F, 7E, 7D, 7C, 7B, 7A, 79, and 78. Okay, these are the bit addressable area. Sir, over here we can very easily calculate the address because we know it's a small table. We can easily calculate, sir. R3 of bank 2, R3 of bank 2, what are the locations? Starting from 10H, so 10, 11, 12, 13, so it will be 13. But in this table, say maybe in between over here, there is a locations that is 52, there is the locations. This is a bit address. This 52H is nothing but a bit address. This 52H is nothing but a bit address. Then calculate what are the byte address. Then calculate what are the byte address and which bit. Calculate the what are the byte address and which bit. Sir, how it's possible? My question is clear. If bit address is 52H, if bit address is 52H, then calculate the byte address. Byte address matlab 20 to 20F. Which byte address? And which bit means D0 to D7 means which one? D0, D1, D2, D3, which one? So 52 you are given, that is the bit address. Then calculate the byte address and which bit. How it will be done? Just see first. 52 converting into the decimal. 52H converting into the decimal. 2 to the power 0, 5 to the power 1. So 5 into 16 to the power 1. Plus 2 into 16 to the power 0. 80 plus 2, so 82. Right? This is 82. Sir, every memory location have 8 locations. Every memory locations have 8 locations. So 82 divided by the 8. So 10 is the result and 2 is the remainder. 10 is the result and 2 is the remainder. Therefore, the byte address is equal to, therefore the byte address is equal to, what will be the byte address? Byte address is equal to, sir, what is the starting? 20. 20 is the starting address, sir. So 20 plus 10. 10 is a hexadecimal 0A. So 10 plus 0A, that is 2A. Right? Next, sir, what is the remainder? 2. So it will be D2 bit. So 2AH is the byte address and D2 bit. 2AH is the bit byte address and D2 bit. In this way, you can calculate the byte address and bit. You have any queries, you can ask. It's clear to everyone, byte address, how to calculate the byte address and which bit. Calculate to everyone. It's very easy. I'm just dividing it the 8 because every memory locations have 8 locations. Why I'm adding with 20? Because the base address is 20. So I'm starting with 20.
and you know and what are the remainder? 2. So D2. So if remainder is 9, it's not possible at all because you are dividing by 8. How remainder will be 9? How remainder will be 8? Remainder may be from 0 to 7. Remainder may be from 0 to 7. If 0, then D0 bit. If if 7, then D7 bit. Anyone, if 5, so D5 bit. What will be the remainder? That bit. So, next I just see the internal structure. These are the internal structure, 32 locations, 80 from 30 to 7F. These are the called, you know, these are the called our scratch pad area, whatever I discuss. And, you know, 16 byte 20 to 2F is a bit addressable area, what I already discussed. And it is mentioned. And these are the, you know, direct. This is the, you know, SFR register, whatever I discuss. This is also direct, and these are the SFR registers, 00 to 7F internal RAM, and then SFR. These are the bank with their corresponding locations. I already discussed. Just see bank 0, 00 to 07H, bank 1, 08 to 0FH, bank 2, 10 to 17H, and bank 3 is nothing but a 18 to 1FH. I already discussed which I am. Next, 20 to 2F. Total bit, sir, is not possible for me to draw the whole table, but you know, over here it is drawn 20. There are 8 locations, you know, 00 to 07. 2F is nothing but a, you can see 78 to 7F, and so on. 00 to 7F is there, right? This is the total internal RAM. It is starting from 00 to, you know, 1F. It is a bank 0, bank 1, bank 2, bank 3, 4 bank, then bit addressable area, then general purpose RAM or scratch pad, whatever you say, 30 to 7F. That is the total internal RAM structure, whatever I discuss. This is a program. You just see what is the PSW.4. PSW.4, I already told to you. Just you see PSW.4, if you recall, PSW.4 is nothing but RS1, and PSW.3 is nothing but RS0. What are the by default value of PSW? By default value of PSW, I already discussed. By default of PSW is 00H at reset condition. You know, PSW is 00H. So what are the value of byte 00H, the total register? So what are the value of RS0 and RS1? It should be 00H. So by default, always bank 0 is selected. By default, always bank 0 is selected. By default, always bank 0 is selected. I am repeat once again, by default value of PSW is nothing but a, is nothing but a 00H as 00H. So we can say 00H is nothing but a bank 0 will be selected. 00 is nothing but a bank 0 is selected. So we can easily say for bank 0, it is a 00. By default, our bank is 00 selected. Next is question is coming, that coming, you know, if I'm talking about this register, so this bank is by default using. This bank is by default using. So what are the value of, you know, stack pointer? What are the value of stack pointer by default? I already told to you that is 07H. By default value of stack pointer is 07H. So why 07H? You know, just listen very carefully. It's very important one. Why 07H by default value of stack pointer? You know, whenever any data pushed into the stack means, mu means, you know, you are given 08H means you are given 08H. How it's done, sir? Push 07, push any value. Push means push pop operation. So you are given an instruction like push 50. So 50H memory location content will be pushed into the stack. I am not explaining the push operations, just that's why I'm given not going into the details. But whenever I coming into the push pop operations, I will be explain later on. But just listen carefully. Before pushed a data into the stack, stack pointer always increment by one in 8051. Not for everywhere. It's valid for 8051. So whenever pushed a data into the stack, before pushed into the data into the stack, stack pointer is incremented by one. Stack pointer is incremented by one. What does it mean? It means stack pointer from 07 to, stack pointer is 07 to 08 because incremented by one. So it will be 07 to 08. So the data will be stored in the first, that is over here. So by default, stack using bank one, by default stack using bank one, but by default register using bank zero. That is the difference, you know, bank zero and bank one. I am repeat once again, by default, you know, register is, as you know, RS zero and RS one value is 00H. So by default bank zero is selected. So whenever you are using the R0 to R7, bank zero is selected. But whenever you push the data into the stack, by default, this bank is selected, means it will not be overlapped with each other. That's why the value of stack pointer is 07H. That's why the value of stack pointer is 07H. You know, by default, you are using the bank one, bank zero, but stack is using the bank one. So you know, stack and the whatever the register you are using, it will not be overlapped in any time. That's why by default value of stack pointer is 07H. You can change. No issues for that, but by default value is 07H. To don't overlap with registers and bank, you know, stack. That's why the value is 07H. Next, we are coming into the next. Sorry. This one, set BPSW.4. What is the meaning? You know, everyone can see. What is the value of PSW.4 means RS1, PSW.3 means RS0. So RS0 and RS1 both by default is 00. Both by default is 00. Next, RS0 and RS1, what will be the value? Just listen very carefully. What are the value RS0 and RS1? Both are now is 00H. Both are now is 00H. So bank 1, it will be 01H. Bank 2, it will be 10H, and bank 3, it will be 11H. So by default, both are 00. By default, both are 00. Whenever I am using setbpsw.4, forget about those instructions. Setbpsw.4 means is nothing but it will be 1. I will be explained today in a, whenever we, our class will be starting from 4 o'clock. We are talking about the instructions. Then it will be understood what is the function of setb. But now you are understood that setbpsw.4 means it bit is will be 1. So this RS1 will be 1. What are the value of RS0? It should be 0 because by default its value is 0. So 10. Which bank is selected? Bank 2 will be selected. That's why select bank 2. So it will be automatically select bank 2. It will be automatically select bank 2. Right. Next, move R0 comma hash 99H. What are the value of move R0 comma hash 99H? Is nothing but a, it's nothing but a, in R0 it will be stored 99, in R1 it will be stored 85, in R2 it will be 3F, in R7 it will be 63, in R5 it will be 12H. So R0 of bank 2, what are the locations of R bank, you know, which bank is selected? Bank 2. What are the value of R0? 99H. What are the value of R1? 85H. What are the value of R2? You know, 33FH. So what are the locations of R0 of bank 2? R0 of bank 2? R0 of bank 2? 10H. R0 of bank 2 is nothing but a 10H. So that's why I'm written over here. RAM location 10H has the value 99H. RAM location 10H has the value 99H. Next, what are the value of R1 of bank 2? 11H. So RAM locations, you know, RAM locations 11H has the value 85H. What is the value of R2? R2 is nothing but a 12H. You can see and check. R2 is nothing but a 12H. Similarly, R7 is nothing but a 17H. These are the location as bank 2 is selected. So 12H has the value 3FH. Next, R7 is 17. 17H has the value 63H. R5 is nothing but a 15H. 15H has the value 12H. That's why I'm written. Next, one question in my mind, sir, if there is another line of the instruction, should be PSW.3. Set B PSW.3, then what will be happen? Anyone can give the answer in your chat box or in, you know, you can in a microphone, no issues. Set B PSW.4 is there. Another, I am written another instruction, set B PSW.3. Which bank will be selected? Set B PSW.4 already is there. I am written another instruction. That is set B PSW.4, same program. Then which bank will be selected in the first? So there are two instructions, set B PSW.3, then set B PSW.4. Which bank will be selected? It will be select bank 3. Bank 3. Because set B PSW.4 means one. If I am given another instruction, set B PSW.3, that is also one. So 1-1 means bank 3. So bank 3 will be selected. Then this location of R0, not will not be 10. It will be something like that. These locations, that is 10, that is 18. Similarly, those locations will be reflect in these kind of things. Okay, and now this portion is over. Whatever discussed in the yesterday, next is the SFR registers. I will be discuss whenever I'm in a second half, that is a 4 o'clock. And if you have any kind of queries, you can ask. I don't know whether sir or madam you are enjoying or not. I try my level best to, you know, give. If you have any kind of, you know, queries, you can give.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
It was a good session, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. And my second sessions will be, ma'am, at 4 o'clock.
Yes.
So you can enjoy, you know, because today there will not be problem like 100 participation and all. It is increased. So it will be done. No issue.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much to everyone. And you know, you end of the sessions, you are still waiting. It's a very pleasure for me. You have a lots of work. Now I know. And be safe always. Be stay at home. Thank you. Thanks to everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.